Okay, so hello everyone. My name is Michał Staśkiewicz, and today I want to show with you some stuff about the Ember Octane and things that you should know about it. Okay, so first, what is Ember Octane? It's the first edition of the Ember editions. But you can think, well, what is the edition? What are the editions in Ember? So many people ask about that, and this is the tweet from the YCATS that he's saying that Ember editions, it's not a single release of Ember, so 3.8 or 3.9, it's not the edition. But to understand what are the editions, we need to think about the Ember release cycle and the model in which we are developing the Ember. So this is the way in which we are releasing new changes to the Ember. Every 6 weeks we have new stable release, and the current beta is promoted to the new stable release. And the cycle is one by one every 6 weeks. If some features aren't ready for the deployment, they are postponed to the beta, and the stuff that is done is released, and the other stuff is postponed. And every 6 weeks we have this release. It's called the train model. But this approach has several problems. The first one is hard to track the best practices and how the framework itself evolving. The changes are released every 6 weeks, and if somebody is not following them, it's really hard to don't lose the focus and keep track on everything. Another group of people that not using the Ember, but there is a group of people that just watching the framework from the other perspective, maybe those guys developing other frameworks and want to follow what's new there. And with this train model, it's really hard for them to know what's new, when is some biggest changes. And there is even small group of people that think the Ember is still 1.7, and they even know that there is some new cool stuff. And also it's hard for the contributors in Ember itself, because the documentation and the marketing sometimes are in the behind, the current master is released, and there is some mismatch between the documentation, the current release, and it's hard to track those things even for the contributors. Yeah, and for this, some guy involved the additions. Addition is some part of features that are connected together in some logical way or some other stuff. So few releases with some part of work that is done and it's working, it's stable, is called addition. If you want to read more about additions, there is a link for the RFC where everything is described. And the first edition of Ember is called Ember Octane. And this edition is focused on performance and productivity. So every new feature is somewhere in this terminology. Okay, so what should ship in the Ember Octane? The Octane is planned for this year. Some of those features are already implemented, some are still in progress, and some of them are still waiting for the next contributors to start them. And the first big change in the editions is no jQuery by default. We all know that Ember was tight coupled with the jQuery, but now the Ember itself can live without the jQuery, so jQuery times is gone, and every new app launch without the dependency with jQuery. Native JavaScript classes. So every person that I know who is using React or something else is blaming the Ember community that, oh, but you have not the classes, and the syntax is weird, and this is so legacy, blah, 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 blah. And with the Ember editions, this is example of this the syntax that we have now in Ember. So you can see there is this component extent, and we are passing this props to the constructor. But with the Ember Octane, we have new beautiful six classes, so every React guy is familiar with those. And we have also decorators, which allows us to in more declarative way describe the dependencies, computed properties, actions. Another big chunk of work that was done by the core team are Glimmer components. Mostly they are bring some faster, much more elegant way to declaring the components. And here we have an example with this old classic Ember component, and you can see that there is a lot of stuff done there. We have this tag name, class names, and every newcomer to the Ember was struggling. Oh, what is this? What should I do? Where should I put my classes? And that wasn't so straightforward. But with Glimmer components, we have much more powerful templating language with Glimmer. So we have splatributes, like I think in React. Every prop is marked with the at sign, and the component itself is much tighter and cleaner. There are only the hooks and some action definitions. Everything else lands in the templates. So the syntax is much more React-like now. Yeah, this is my favorite one, the element modifiers. Here you can see that we are creating some hooks on the component, and then we can do some stuff after our component will be mounted. Here is the example. So in this hook DidRender is always called when component will be rendered. It's obvious, but this is the example how we are dealing with the components now, and there is a lot of logic that is checking, okay, the render was done, but what should I do now to mount or do some stuff with the DOM? But element modifiers introduce the new syntax that allow us add some custom logic in more declarative way. So if we have even small div in our application, we can add the modifiers there and just pass the reference for action. So in a simple way, we can set up the Popper or other JavaScript library that need custom element just there. And this change was enforced by this semantic with here. In this old syntax, our component has the outer HTML with some wrapper. So every component has its own HTML div, and the hooks are always binded to this div. But with Glimmer components, there is no outer div, the wrapper one. So now everything lands in the template. And I really like this syntax because it's much clearer. If we see the template, we almost instantly see, okay, after insert, there is some action. After destroy, some other action. Yeah. And another feature that is, there is a lot of work to do still, but the documentation is not as good as it should for now in Ember, because there are some mismatch between the versions, and the scripts that generate the documentation have some bugs, and sometimes the documentation is gone, and upgrading also is not so easy because there is a lack of this stuff. But the Ember learning team is working hard to bring the first class documentation to the Octane release. Yeah. Also for this release and addition is planned the incremental rendering and rehydration, but nobody even starts that yet. But I saw some discussion on the Discord channel, so I think it should start in the next weeks. Yeah, like I said before, there a lot of work is done already, but a lot of work is still in progress and to do. So if you have some free time, every hour of help matters. If you have 2 hours and can to create some stuff for Ember, just do it. If you don't know what is to do, you can just join the Ember Octane channel on the Discord, or just look on this Octane tracking issue. There is a list of everything that should land in Ember with this Octane release, and you can pick the issues are labeled with help wanted, and we can just pick one and do some work for the Ember community. Yeah, and that's all. Thanks.